unexpectedly urgent.
President Rodrigo Duterte has tapped a seasoned diplomat to replace the disgraced former Foreign Affairs Secretary Perfecto Yasay Jr. But in the words of Palacanang, Undersecretary Enrique Manalo is just warming the seat for someone else.
He will hold the position until the president appoints a new secretary. All right? In the meantime, Yusek Manalo is an excellent transition man.
Malacanang did not say who Duterte was actually waiting for. But the president earlier indicated the top diplomatic post would likely go to a political appointee, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano. Cayetano is not allowed to an executive post for a year since losing in the 2016 vice presidential race. In the meantime, he's been tagging along in many of Duterte's foreign trips. Former Ambassador Jose Apolinario Lozada believes Manalo should be appointed permanently. He says it would be useless to put a mere caretaker of Manalo's caliber to serve for only about 2 months.
He has the qualification, he has the brains, he knows the issues, he has the respect of his colleagues, and I think he will be a good captain of the DFA ship to lead us out of the mess that had happened a couple of months before this.
This mess is what Lozada calls the lack of clarity in the administration's foreign policy, especially in dealing with China. This will be the same challenge that will confront Acting Secretary Manalo.
Well, the DFA will be continuing to do its job. Yesterday is already history, so today we are, of course, continuing, as I said, all our priorities, and one of them, of course, is to promote the interests of our country, among the Filipino people, so just to assure everyone that the DFA is here, it's working, and will continue to serve the people.
Because Manalo is a career diplomat, much, of course, is expected of him, especially for someone replacing a secretary with no previous diplomatic experience. But this doesn't mean Manalo sought no advice from his former boss.
We met him today. He gave us lots of tips, but his biggest tip was to say that to do our job with integrity and to maintain our professionalism in the department, and to always have the interests of the country at heart.
Yasay's own integrity was put in question at the commission and appointments. On Wednesday, the commission unanimously rejected Yasay's nomination because he did not tell the truth about his previous American citizenship. In a Facebook post, Yasay maintained he did not lie before the commission.
It is, of course, embarrassing for the Philippines, especially because the Philippines is currently the chairman of ASEAN. Mm-hmm. And he has been, of course, meeting with his counterparts from the ASEAN countries. And it just shows, of course, the character of the individual.
The diplomats believe the controversy did not have to come to this, if only Yasay had been properly vetted, or if Yasay himself disclosed the whole truth right at the beginning. Christian Isguera, ABS-CBN News.